Don't even think about ratting me out. My tracks are covered. Yours ain't.
Like the allongé?
I practiced.
I think you pulled it a little too long.
Oh, come on! It's not encrypted code, for God's sakes. It's just a bloody coffee. Oh, hooray! It's our old friend.
Hey there! I just got a call about picking up another transfer.
Oh? You said you were here to see me.
Yes, that is one of the perks. Let's see it. A conference in Chicago. Very nice. Thanks for this. We'll be in touch.
Ciao, Rebecca. Text me.
Stuff it, Hastings.
That's unsettling. To think we're not even safe where we work.
Well done, friend. Very well done. Apologies for my temper tantrum there. You are with the good guys, I promise. We'll keep you safe. Trust me. Go on back to work. We'll be in touch.
Security was at my desk.
Is that what happened?
Yeah, they confiscated my items.
use this phone more than a few times to record anything. Hey, Dad. So, we're all here in New York at the motel. It's, Queens, actually. In Astoria, near the NQ. Rebecca's off getting batteries for something. Sean's in his room doing whatever Sean does. And, you're out getting some food. Me? Well, I'm supposed to be getting ready to break into some offices in the financial district. Feels just like prepping for one of your old training drills, actually. 10 years go by, and then you show up, and it's like I was never gone. And we're right back to the ball busting and the conspiracies and the paranoia. Only this time, I believe you. I believe every word. You know, I don't even think you know the half of it. I don't think you know how much I've seen. How much I've learned in just a few weeks. Everything, really. I feel like I've lived 1,000 years, or 10,000, maybe. It's impossible to explain. But when you see that much of the world through the eyes of so many, you can't help but be sad. And to see all these incredible, intelligent people fight the same battles, make the same mistakes over and over again. Because culture and knowledge and history, these things, they aren't passed on through our genes. Every kid on Earth needs to relearn the basics. How to live, how to survive, how to stand up for what's right. So much is lost in the transfer. So much is added, every generation. It's a shame. I mean, over and over, everything must be learned again. I met Clay, Dad. Clay Gesmeric, in the Animus. I knew him by his Abstergo handle, Subject 16. My predecessor. And he showed me things. He passed them to me, just before he died. Or got deleted, or whatever. Everything he'd learned, everything he'd seen, God, how do I talk about this? So, guess you trained him. After I left, he really looked up to you, and now that I've seen through his eyes, I think I understand why. I'm glad you had him around, even if I wasn't there. The things he showed me. Unbelievable things. And I never... Shit. All right, I'll be back in a second.
Thank you.
desk.
Our researchers looked into the life of Altair Ibn Lahad, hoping to find a biography that might serve as a positive role model for Abstergo's global outreach programs. Unfortunately, this renegade assassin proved to be no such thing. In much of his footage, we see a man gleefully flouting some of his culture's most entrenched taboos with an arrogance that borders on messianic.
Altair! No! This is not our way! To burn a man's body is forbidden!
Many of our researchers felt that the arguments articulated by Altair's rival, a man known as Abbas, were clearer and more cogent than any we heard from Altair. I recently put in a request that more effort be dedicated to locating one of Abbas's descendants, if any exist. It's clear to us that Altair's transgressions were the primary motivation behind the ultimate dissolution of his despicable order by the middle of the 13th century. We therefore strongly recommend a pass on this property, in favor of a more agreeable and inspiring figure from this era.
I've an awful feeling about this. You'll be hurt out there. I couldn't handle that.
I'll be careful, I promise. And when I'm flush with coin and set up, I'll send for you. I will.
Caroline, come away! Don't exert yourself!
I can't promise I'll come, Edward. If you leave on this fool's errand, I cannot promise anything.
Don't give up on me, Caroline! Not when I need your faith the most.
Putting some shape to your sentiments?
Just a short letter home. I reckon she's past caring anyway.
Oh, you're a hard heart that should be softer.
Or soft in parts that should be hard.
And how is it you're so keen for his hard parts, Mr. Rackham?
You'd like to know my secrets, would you?
Oh, aye. Give me a small hint, like. Or a large one, if you're an upright gentleman.
Open your hand.
Oh!
Who's shooting?
Might be them ships sliding into port.
Jesus.
My thanks. Arrivederci.
Be hanged. King George has grown tired of our shenanigans.
Who's the grim fella?
That's Captain Woods Rogers. Not a man I want seeing my face.
We desire a parley with the men who call themselves governors of this island.
Charles Vane, Ben Hornigold, and Ed Thatch. Come forth, if you please.
Hear about the king's pardon, I reckon.
What the hell is Hornigold doing?
Lily-livered punk!
What are you men up to?
I am grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold. I assumed our reception would be a troubled one.
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say, but of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. And it's a fairer shake than I expected to see from any pirate. But I promise fair treatment to all who hear me out.
Only wait a while longer, Governor Rogers. These rascals will show their true colors in time.
Calm, Commodore Chamberlain. I have given Captain Hornigold my word that we will be equitable.
Won't do you a lick of good. Men like him are a blight on His Majesty's reputation and a peculiar cancer afflicting the new world. The King wants them eradicated above all else.
Is this the town square?
As close to one as we've ever had.
Incredible. It's no cleaner than a dog's kennel. Captain Hornigold, please call your men.
Rackham, Vane, the governor's come calling. Bring Burgess and Corcoran as well.
Span out, lads! And take this shanty town as if it were your own!
Aye. He has been particularly ineffective in bringing about this change, hasn't he? And has failed all attempts until now.
Talk about His Majesty, Governor. You're here at his pleasure.
I have my methods, Commodore, and I expect you to honor them to the letter. Dispersed, a lot of you. Make way for the King's emissaries.
Out of the way, you bastards! Go on!
Commodore Chamberlain, please see that all merchants, masons, and carpenters are rounded up and brought to me this afternoon. We must see about repairing this fortress.
Every goddamn ship not flying the King's colors. To do otherwise projects a certain weakness in our bearing.
Silence, Commodore! I am the goddamn governor here, serving at the King's pleasure, and I will make the bloody decision. Is that clear?
Sir. Aye, sir. Your wishes are clear as crystal.
Commodore, we're in position.
Governor Rogers believes he can make men of these monkeys yet. I do not. Return to your post and await my orders.
Down!
You come back!
Beyond the seas, every such pirate and pirate so surrendering him or themselves, as aforesaid, shall have our gracious pardon of and for such his or their piracy or piracies. By him or them committed before the 5th of January next ensuing. And we do hereby strictly charge and command all our admirals, captains, and other officers at sea, and all our governors and commanders of any forts, castles, or other places in our plantations, and all our officers, civil and military, to seize and take such of the pirates. I pray you take the prudent course, gentlemen, and accept the king's pardon as soon as your hearts allow. For until such time, all of you will be confined in Nassau. I am sorry for this, but in lieu of a public trial, this pardon is your best bet.
The governor puts it far too brightly, maggots. Take this message home. Accept the king's protection forthwith, or we will raise this town to its foundation and stretch your bloody necks.
Peace, Commodore Chamberlain. We are messengers, not executioners. Not yet.
Oh, thank you, sir. God save you.
Look on this as a stroke of fortune, lads. We should take the king's pardon and salvage what dignity we
Peace.
Own.
I'll be hanged before I surrender to that bobby.
Check your head, Vane. We had here a rare opportunity, a chance to take something base and shape it into a government made and maintained by men of vision. But in 2 years, we pissed it away. I won't make that mistake again.
It's truth he's telling, and you whelps can't handle it. But you forecastle-headed fuddlers. See you at the gallows.
You'll all be dead men! Bastards!
I need a drink. Turncoat. Makes me bloody ill to think on how many times I've put up with Hornigold and his self-righteous shite.
Verily, you are a man of principle, Captain Hornigold. A man I believe I can trust with my best ideas.
Faith, and we'll survive this, Charles, with our pride intact.
Well, that's confidence. You brewed a plan I might get a taste of?
Nassau is over, that's plain to see. I say we skip out tonight and regroup at my compound.
Fair enough. What's your angle?
The Brits have brought their supplies ashore, see? If we nick some gunpowder and pine pitch, we can build a fire ship and send it straight at the blockade, blasting it to smithereens.
Aye. We'll use Rackham's ship. You're a capable captain.
My conscience is clear.
Right. Well, you get the gunpowder, I'll secure the pine pitch.
Oi! Into the... Ugh.
Get out of the bush, you trap!
Hey! Get out of that gross! Yourselves, you dullards!
Come on, boys, you're lagging.
It's this bloody hemp.
Lieutenant.
Aye, sir.
The Commodore fears a revolt is nigh. His orders are to sink every goddamn pirate ship now anchored in that harbor, tonight.
Despite the governor's wishes, sir.
This is a direct order, soldier. You will take position on the grounded galleon and await the Commodore's further orders. Is that clear?
Aye, sir.
The conniving bastard. Someone ought to slit the Commodore's throat before he gets a chance to bark those orders.
You think so?
We're dead in the water otherwise.
All right, I'll kill him.
Your brains are baked. I won't take no part in killing the Commodore. Not one of the King's men.
We can't risk our good fortune. I'll be waiting for you.
Between them two, Rogers and Chamberlain. What's the issue?
Commodore don't think much of civilians here. And there's a rumor going around that Rogers is some kind of Jacobite, or worse, that he's a Catholic.
Such a picturesque view. Really? Oh, my.
Capital. Absolutely capital.
I heard the Commodore ranting and raving about Woods Rogers, calling him a heathen and whatnot. What's happened to set them to?
Hush, man. You don't want the Governor's ire brought down on you. He's a mysterious sort.
Well, I'm much more afraid of the Commodore, in truth. He's a serious chap. No such a need.
Stop!
The governor's given us a pardon, Commodore. Don't a man's word mean anything in these times?
Has syphilis clouded your mind? Why scratch and claw to protect such squalor? Your parasites feeding off the industry of honest men.
Much like King George in that respect.
Know your place, peasant! You may have taken my life, but you have not improved your own by any measure.
Does some purpose keep you talking?
If not for that heathen, Governor Rogers, I'd have seen you hanged from your own cross trees. Worm. All of you.
I give you good day, sir.